Hello, and welcome. So what I'm about to do, not surprising, I'm going to pop out the 6502 chip from this working pet once again, set it down, and I'm going to grab the diagnostic board, and I'm going to put it in once again, and I'm sure it is fine, I'm sure it is dandy. Now here is the next magical thing I'm going to try. And just a moment as we slide. Well, no, we're gonna pick up and move. Okay, so here, there are some chips, hang on. Here are the RAM chips in this other board. If you will notice, those ones are socketed. So what I'm going to do, using this RAM or this chip puller that Al Payne gave me, I'm going to pop one RAM chip out of its socket. It has been in there a long time, and it's putting up a good fight. Okay, I'll do a little prying from over here. This is not going particularly well. Give a little twist, give a little twist. That probably will do it. Come on. It is really stuck in there. Okay, it's out. And it is intact. And what kind of chip is this? Okay. It's an NEC-116C-2, it looks like. Okay, well, here's the thing that I'm going to do. I'm going to put the RAM chip that I just removed from that other board in here. Because, and I'm putting it strategically not near where this one was. We'll put it way down. I hope. I looked at all these pins. They looked good. They looked happy. Let me just double check again. Let's see here. Oh, maybe a bit of a twist on it. But they all look pretty fine. There is always the danger of these that have had solder on them being a little sharp and a little more difficult. Okay. I believe it is in. I believe it is good. So now, this was the good pet. I'm going to turn it on. Oh, no, maybe not. Hang on. We'll close it up. Oh. Gee. Just noticing the wire. Oh, of course, the shift lock key is missing. No wonder the wires are dangling. Okay. So now, we'll move up to the monitor, and we'll slide over and get in position, twist a bit, zoom in a bit, get everything just so, and we'll turn this on and see what we see. Okay, now if that chip was indeed bad, the RAM testing should go pretty well until we get to the end, and then it should crap out. Well, It says everything's okay. But see, this was a very subtle failure that was going on, so I don't necessarily believe that. I don't. Let's see here. Okay, that's all right. And I can't, because the socket, or the chips that are in sockets, are not the same, I cannot put the chip I just took out into the same location. I cannot. It's funny, though. I don't know why I put that extra space in there. Oh, yeah, those are the other ROMs. Yes, they are empty indeed. They are. They are indeed empty. Interesting. Well, I guess we're going to see what's what when. Now, I know the desoldering iron is unplugged and cooling. I'm going to get soldering iron. Get everything set up here. So, still always wary. I don't know how long these things hold their heat, and I really don't want to put my fingers on to find out. So, let's get all the cords sorted. Well, that sort of does its thing there. Remember, this was a very subtle little failure. I suppose what I could do, come on, cords. I suppose I could be brave and touch this. Well, the desoldering iron is still a little bit warm. Not bad, but a little bit. So I'm going to leave it on the metal thing from the VIC-20. And I'm going to get the soldering iron and put it on its little holder. And with great care, I will plug it in. Watch the cord. Okay. So here is the PEP doing its thing. It is. I'm thinking. These things happen, you know. So what I might do is turn it off. And open it up. And put this up. And then aim this down into the and you can see all the RAM chips. Here's the light. Should be much brighter. And this is the one that came out of that other machine. It is. And it seems to test as okay in here. But I don't believe it, but you never know. I'm just going by what the diagnostic said, but things, you know, stranger things have happened. I'm going to get this out of here. Come on. Some of these RAM chips are tough. Okay. The RAM chip is out. Now, we'll put the original one back into the socket. I'm suspecting it will go pretty easy, and it does. Perhaps what I should do here, to do the best I can to recreate the trouble, is pop out this one way down here at the end, which is not the same as what I just took out, but it's certainly going to be probably more likely part of what it is. Maybe, possibly. But maybe not. But anyway. Because actually, in the whole way it lists things off, it's being what to check. It goes this way, not across. So we have the RAM chip from the other machine. We'll get it lined up. We'll push it in. We'll turn it on. We'll bring the screen down. And we'll just see if anything else goes squirrely. And so far, oh. So far it's saying it's okay. But is it really? I don't know. Okay. Well, maybe this will not end up being the great savior that I was hoping for. But doesn't matter, we still gotta solder in a new socket. So we will set about doing that. I'm gonna turn this off. Maybe. No, you know what? I'm gonna let it keep testing. I am. And then I'm gonna get things everything all lined up so we can solder in the socket. So stay tuned. We'll see you again soon. Bye for now.